culture.
Ginger Nuts, Carrot Top, El Gingero, Ron Weasley, and Copper Knob are just some of the things I've been called by close family and friends as a ginger person. The nicknames I've been given by those who don't like me, here's looking at you comment section, are even worse. Redheaded people are a rarity in the world, which means there are inevitably plenty of misconceptions and stereotypes about them. So next time you're confronted by an ignorant gingerphobe, or as I like to call him, Adam Cleary, point them in the direction of these facts, and let's break down the walls of gingerism through knowledge, sharing, and love. I'm Adam Wilborn from What Culture, aka the only person in the office who could do this list, and these are 10 unbelievable facts every ginger person should know. Number 10, ancient Greeks thought redheads were vampires. On an episode of South Park, Cartman stirs up fear about gingers by comparing them to vampires. After all, there are aesthetic similarities, including extremely pale skin, aversion to sunlight, and the color red being associated with blood. However, this was an actual legitimate fear held by the ancient Greeks. Yep, the same people that invented democracy and philosophy also held the belief that when redheads died, they turned into vampires. The entire notion is ridiculous, and yet still sounds better than anything seen in Twilight. Number 9. An Irish man was actually convicted because of his hair colour. An Irish man was on trial for alleged disorderly conduct, and you'd think it would be fair to assume that the man would be judged fairly and lawfully based on evidence of his actions, rather than on his physical appearance, especially considering this was in 2001 and not 1601. But this assumption would be wrong, as in a breathtaking miscarriage of justice, the judge said to the man, "I am a firm believer that hair colouring has an effect on temper, and your colouring suggests you have a temper." The judge openly admitted that his decision was influenced by a prejudice based on hair colour, and the man was convicted for disorderly conduct. Number 8. Hitler banned intermarriage with redheads. It's fair to say that I think most people have made their mind up about old Adolf, but in case you haven't, this might swing it. Obviously, Hitler took issue with pretty much everyone. Well, you can go ahead and add gingers to his list of undesirables, as reports say that Hitler banned intermarriages between redheads and non-redheads out of fear of, quote, deviant offspring. Because, I mean, nobody would want deviant kids given the threat that they might, oh, I don't know, grow up to be power-hungry, mass-murdering psychopaths or something. Number 7. There were ginger Neanderthals. Scientists recently discovered that some Neanderthal people likely had the same genetic mutation that gingers have today, which means there was probably some red-headed Neanderthals out there. Just put up the picture of a ginger Captain Caveman, and let's move on, eh? Number 6. Ancient Egyptians and Romans hated gingers too. Who knew Egypt even had gingers? You'd think they'd have at least got a mention in the hieroglyphs. Well, apparently not only did they have them, but surprise, surprise, they didn't like them either. Red hair was associated with the evil god Seth, not that one, who the Greeks knew as Typhon. This dislike for redheads extended into the ancient Greek and Roman communities too. Romans showed their mistrust of the ginger people by giving their red wigs to the people playing slaves in their dramas. Number 5. Christian communities once considered red hair a mark of the devil. In James George Frazer's The Golden Bough, he discusses characteristics of religions throughout history and states that past Christian communities also shared a distaste for red-headed people. According to Frazer, many past Christian communities believed that among the marks of the devil were syphilis, gonorrhea, leprosy, and of course, red hair. Right, one of those things is slightly different to the rest. Who knows where this prejudice came from, but many speculate that old Christian communities believed that Judas was a ginger despite any textual evidence from the Bible. I tell you, we get the blame for fucking everything. Number 4. Gingers are apparently witches too. Among the 45,000 women killed between 1483 and 1784 for witchcraft were, you guessed it, redheads. Witch hunts were a notoriously inexact science, and thousands of women were killed for having suspicious witch marks, one of which was red hair. A stereotype that was unhelpfully furthered in later years when J.K. Rowling created a whole family of Weasleys who practice witchcraft and wizardry. Her magical redheads might have been the most virtuous of the entire wizarding world, but that doesn't hide the fact that they would have been burnt at the stake during the witch hunt heyday, even without expectoing any patronums. Number 3. Aristotle had issues with redheads. Get in line, pal! Even when we look at one of humanity's finest specimens, a man universally associated with incredible accomplishments in logic, physics, biology, medicine, and philosophy, there is still an anti-ginger prejudice. Aristotle himself is reported as once saying, "The reddish are of bad character." Yeah, well, you were wrong about eels, mate. Number 2. A ginger family had to move because of discrimination. This is a cheerful entry, isn't it? Tell you what, if you stick with it, I'll show you a funny picture of me sunburnt at the end. A family in the UK and their 4 children were forced to move out of 3 different homes thanks to bullies who mercilessly attacked them for their hair colour. Their children were bullied at school, their cars were smashed by vandals, and they even had offensive graffiti written on their walls. And where did all this happen? Newcastle. Oh, good. And now we've got through all that, here's me looking like a lobster. Number 1. Red hair and blue eyes is the rarest combination in the world. While the concentration of redheads in the British Isles is pretty high, there are many places in the world where gingers are extremely rare or even non-existent. Anywhere hot, basically. If the entire world's population is taken into account, redheads make up only 1% of the entire planet, making them the rarest natural hair colour in existence. If you take that 1% and examine the breakdown of eye colours, the least common among redheads is blue, which makes the combination of red hair and blue eyes the rarest on Earth. If you're a red-headed, blue-eyed lefty, then you're not only a genetic mutant, but a statistical anomaly. And that's our list. Did we miss any out? Let us know in the comment section below, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I'm Adam, yep, the ginger one from whatculture.com, and I'll see you soon.